So I'll be discussing on my favorite topic, scleral contact lenses. Seen 1508, and later on, basically the initial challenges we had about the oxygen permeability. So there was very less oxygen permeability through the scleral contact lenses. And later on, R&D has happened, material has developed, and now we have a best material available, Boston Exo 2, which permits more than 141 DK for the scleral contact lenses. What are the advantages of scleral contact lenses over the RGP lenses? So basically, it has a pre-corneal fluid reservoir, which keeps the eyes moist all the time. It's comfortable, there's no intolerance issues. As it rests on the sclera, so the tolerance is good, the wearing hours is good, the comfort is good, and doesn't cause any insult to the cornea. It is stable on the eye, and it doesn't cause any scar or any stain on the cornea. So have a look at the scleral contact lenses. It is just vaulting over the sclera. It is not touching the cornea, and it is the lens and the gap is filled by the fluid. So basically, we categorize into mini scleral contact lenses and large scleral contact lenses. Majority of the time, 90-95% of the time, you can easily fit with the macrosphere mini scleral contact lenses, which diameter is around 16 millimeter. So there are so many indications for these specialty lenses, whether the ectasia is primary or secondary. Primary means keratoconus or PMCD. Secondary means when you have a post-lacy ectasias, when you have a high refractive errors after the corneal transplantations. It gives the corneal protections and symptomatic relief in Stevens-Johnson syndrome, dry eye conditions. And definitely with the oculoplasty cases, like you have an improper closure of the lids, trichiasis, entropion, and it prevents from the symblepharon, non-healing defects for the Stevens-Johnson syndromes. Cases like advanced keratoconus with the poor fitted contact lenses. So you can see there's so much of decentration can happen with these kind of lenses. When you give the RGP lens in this such conditions, the lens may be stable in the primary conditions, but in the day routine activities and the patient is driving or, you know, having some adventure sports, so the lens may pop up off the eye. So definitely you need a larger and stable lens on the eye. So as I already discussed, in Stevens-Johnson syndrome, it has been used. Sorry. So you can see there is a keratinization of lid margins, there is a tendency of symblepharon. So it prevents adhesion, it gives the moisture, it gives the comfort, it improves the quality and quantity of the vision. And advanced condition like clearance margin degeneration where RGP lens doesn't stay on the cornea. So see, this is what happens when you have a normal RGP over the keratoconic eyes. So this inducing scar, so which is affecting the transparency of the cornea. So when we give an RGP scleral contact lenses, it doesn't touch the cornea, it doesn't insult the cornea. So the cornea clarity remains same. So you can see in the picture, there's a good apical clearance. So there's no touch. You will see a pool. Conditions like congenital corneal anesthesia. So when there is a no sensation, no blink, so there is more tendency of, you know, to have a dryness, recurrent corneal erosions. So to prevent that, we give a miniscule contact lenses. Condition like Stevens-Johnson syndromes, post-herpes zoster, like we have a case where you have a non-healing epithelial defect and we shifted into a macrosphere miniscule contact lens and it helped in improving that defect. You can see there's a clarity in the picture also, although it's halfly cutted. So whatever the condition you have, whatever attitude disorder you have, it will mask all the irregularities and improve your sight to the best potentials. See, this is all what you have challenges with the larger diameter lenses as well. So macrosphere miniscale lenses can be fit in the angular blepharon when you have a good aperture. So the insertion technique is not like this. This is the wrong technique. So this is the right technique, where you have to put your chin down close to the neck, head down parallel to the floor, and the lens has to be fully filled with the fluid and insert the lenses. And you examine the patient and you see a good clearance, there is a no touch. Always remember to put a fluorescein into the lens, wet the saline, wet the fluid and see the fitting. So there should not be a touch, there should not be any dark spots, there should not be compression over the sclera. So the indication doesn't end there. There are so many indications like post graft. In post graft, you have a multi-curvature cornea, where it's very challenging. It's very easy to fit on a keratoconic eye, and it's rather than fitting on a post graft eyes. So it takes a lot of chair time, but still end result will not be satisfactory with the RGP lenses in post grafts. So definitely the miniscule lenses gives a good vault, good clearance. See the beautiful clearance. You see there is no compression. So this is the perfect fit. Well, many times it happens, patients go for this surgical procedure to get rid of glasses or contact lenses completely, but still the end result is not predictable. So even after intacts, you need to give a miniscule lens in some of the cases. And post-refractive scars, regularities like post-RK. So you can see there's no compression on the sclera. And you enjoy the clear vision. So apart from this, you need to have a good care and maintenance system for the specialty lenses. Thanks to Silverline Laboratories, a specialty division of Puricon, who keeps doing a new research and development for the lenses and the solutions as well. So recently we have developed this GP-Fresh solutions, which is recommended for the RGPs and miniscule contact lenses. The TrueFresh has recently launched for the soft contact lenses. The MacSpace line is recommended for this miniscule lenses. So we have a GP-Fresh which can also be used with the hybrid lenses as well. So we have done trial in about 100 of the cases, and we have a good satisfactory outcome with that. So there's no ocular discomfort, no ocular irritations, no redness. The wearing hours are good. The comfort is good. So the take-home matches is the larger diameter contact lenses have their resulting points beyond the corneal borders and believed to be the among the best in the vision correction option for the irregular corneas. They can postpone, even prevent the surgical intervention as well as decrease the risk of the corneal scarring. Thank you.